every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Grace and peace and good morning to each and every one of you. Welcome once again to Fresh Start. This is Pastor Daryl Fair, and I'm excited to get into the Word of God with you this morning. I trust that these last several days in Isaiah chapter number 55 have been a blessing to you as we seek to apply an understanding of the Word of God into our faith walk. We call this morning devotion Fresh Start because the Bible says in Lamentations chapter number 3, verse 23, that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you, and great is his faithfulness to me. Well, let's go back to Isaiah 55, verses 8 through 11. We understand by now that this particular passage of scripture helps us to understand the concept and the principle of confessing the Word of God. It's important that we understand that we're not confessing what we're confessing based upon our earthly desires. We're confessing and decreeing what has come out of heaven. And we know what has come out of heaven. We know what has come out of the mind of God and the will of God because we have the baptism of the Holy Spirit. And because we have the baptism of the Holy Spirit, we have a direct link, according to Romans chapter number 8, verses 26 and 27. We have a direct link into the mind and the will of God. So we are now confessing what has come out of heaven. And then we understand now that when we confess God's word and God's will in the earth realm, we are making things happen. This is why understanding verse number 10, as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. I have to confess God's word. I have to confess divine intellect in the earth realm, because this is how confession works. It shall not return unto me void. Whatever I'm declaring that God has said about my life, it will make things happen in the earth realm. And here's the confidence that this particular passage of scripture works with. The Bible says, not only will it not return back to us void, but it shall accomplish that which I please. It will accomplish what I please. In other words, there was something that I am desiring based upon what God has placed in my spirit, because my desires should be his desires. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All these things shall be added to you. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he, that is the Lord, will give me what I should desire. And so now that I know what he desires for my life, now that I understand what God is saying about my life, I am now confessing his word in my life. That word that has come out of the divine intellect of God, I am speaking it now in the earth realm, and things are going to happen. What I'm speaking does not have, catch this, it does not have the right to come back to me without doing what it was designed to do. The word of God does not have the right to come back to me without doing what that word was designed to do. We see that point of reference there quickly in the scripture. It shall not return unto me void, but it will accomplish that which I please. There is something that I am desiring based upon what God has said, because I'm desiring what he wants. It shall accomplish. Put it in the chat this morning. I haven't asked you to put much in the chat lately, but put it in the chat. It shall accomplish. It shall accomplish. It shall accomplish. Which, he says, that which I please. And then it says, it shall prosper in the thing, that is, that which I'm praying for. And then he says, whereto I sent it. Okay. It will prosper, it will accomplish rather, what I wanted to accomplish. Then he says, it will prosper in the area that I'm praying for, in the area that I'm in faith for, whereunto I sent it. This is why it's so important for us to confess the word of God, because I am sending the word. I am sending the word to the area that I'm praying for. Every time I confess God's word, I am sending God's thoughts, God's will, God's intellect, God's desires. I am speaking those things in the direction of what I'm praying for. So if I'm praying about my finances, if I'm praying about my health, if I'm praying about my business, if I'm praying about my mental health, if I'm praying about my job, if I'm praying about decisions that I need to make in the future, there's some moves I need to be able to make. And so if I'm praying about those things, every time I confess God's word, every time I confess what God is saying, I am sending the word to that area. So I'm sending the word to my health. I'm sending the word to that situation in my place of employment where I'm working. I am sending that word into my relationships. I'm sending that word into my partnerships. I am speaking God's word over my business, over my household. And as I speak God's will for his as I speak God's will concerning this area of my life, every time I speak it, I'm sending his word. And so my mouth is being used as an arrow to shoot the word of God, rather, to shoot the word of God in the direction of what I'm praying for. And the more I speak it, again, the more it waters the ground of my faith and is going to make it bring forth and it's going to make it bud. But I've got to stay in faith, believing and confessing the word of God. Remember in Mark chapter number 11, I close with this, that in Mark chapter number 11, we believe we receive when we pray. We believe we receive when we pray. I want to say it again. We believe we receive when we pray. When we say, when we pray, when we say, when we articulate the mind of God, the intellect of God, the will of God from heaven in the earth realm, we are declaring and sending the word in that area. So spend some time today sending the word to your health, sending the word to your family, sending the word to your relationships, sending your word, sending God's word, God's will, God's way into every area of your life, and watch what God begins to do. I pray this is making sense, and I pray that God willing, I'll see you in the morning. God bless.